Good evening, everybody. Welcome you all to the session on international business, aspect of international trade, which is what are the factors which are behind the international trade and why has it gained in prominence over the years. The first and foremost being there is a differential cost between various countries. So the relative cost advantage, as it is called, if a product has to be produced in one country and how much does the same product cost for producing in a different country is what you're calling as relative cost. Coming to the next aspect of what another reason for international trade to gain prominence is the reciprocal demand or the what is called as the elasticity of demand for various products. Now, we understand that countries engage in these international trades to gain the efficiency, to improve upon the efficiency. Now, to what extent this international trade takes place between two countries is dependent on the kind of products that they are able to export and able to import. Next, size of the participating countries. Size of the participating countries is also an important factor. If you are a very large country with huge demand and production facilities, you will be in a position to gain from the international trade by the virtue of being able to produce in large volumes and also procure in large volumes. So your gains of trade go up by the size of your economic engagement with the world. Next, level of income in the country. This is also an important factor. If you look at countries with a higher per capita income vis-a-vis countries with a lower per capita income, they are able to, the countries with a higher per capita income are able to shop for products and save much more, so to say, by the virtue of an international trade. So the level of income being high, the possibility of engaging in the international trade and gaining thereby from that is also much higher.